Don't touch it.
So I'm gonna kind of help you guys out a little bit differently than the first hour. So that's the good thing about being the second hour. You figure out what works better. Okay, so here we go. Algebraic proofs. A proof. I can't just say. So like, actually, Nick corrected me earlier. I said basketball, the superior athletes, and he's like, no, hold up, wait. They don't have the best record. They don't bring in the most revenue, blah, blah, blah. So, what we're going to learn here today is I can't just make any kind of statement unless I have the proof to back it up.
Okay? You can be the 45th president of the United States. Huh? Never mind.
What did you say? I just heard something about president of the United States. All right. So, what we're going to start is proofs. We're going to have statements. Nick, I will stand you up. Go ahead and remove those so I can see when your eyes are awake and alert, please. And I have a clipboard ready. We had problems in the other class, too.
What's the clipboard for?
To stand and write your notes so you stay awake. We're not doing these.
That's torture. Like, that should be illegal.
Breaking amendment.
All right. Here we go. Do not freak out about these. You have used all but three of them. You just didn't know it. Okay, so watch this. You need to write a little note by addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. And the key about these is it has to happen on both sides of the equal sign. And that's going to make sense here in a minute because I'm going to show you an example. Okay? So the key to addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division property of equality is it happens on both sides of the equal sign.
Ow.
Solve for x. What would be the first thing you would do?
I'd find out what x is.
Plus 1.
Alright, so I would add 1. Now listen. Did this addition happen on both the left and the right side of the equal sign?
Yes.
Yes. This is addition. So that's an example. It happened on both sides. From here I get 2x equals 4. Now what do I do?
6.
2x equals 2.
How'd you get
6?
Six. I'm sorry.
You knew that.
Now you divide 2 to each side.
Divide by 2.
Division prop.
Okay, why is this a division prop?
A prop.
What sides?
Happened on the left, happened on the right. So we see that? Well, watch this.
Prop or prop?
Okay. What if I gave you that one and I said, let's start solving it? What's the first thing you would do?
Combine like terms.
I would combine like terms, and that would be
4. Subtract 4.
Well, I have a question, because like I said, we are going to have to justify everything that we do. Is this addition prop?
Yeah. No.
No subtraction.
Subtraction prop?
Because you're subtracting.
You don't do it from each side, so it's just addition.
It didn't happen on both sides. All I did was join like terms. What we call that is simplify. Oh. Whenever we don't do anything but we stay on one side, it's just simplify. Okay? So everything over there happened on both sides. I added on the left and I added on the right. Something moved over or back across the equal sign. Nothing moved across the equal sign here, did it? So it's just simplify. See the difference there? You've been using all of these properties when you've solved equations. Okay, so this is nothing new. We've just given it a fancy name. All right, so keeping on that same, let's talk about substitution. What if I did give you that and then I said, 2x minus 1 equals some number, and x is equal to 2. How would you tell me?
2 times 2.
How'd you do that? What'd you do?
They're both beside each other. Wait, what do you mean? I don't get what
you're
asking.
How did you know this was a 2?
Huh? Because it says x equals 2.
So what'd you do? Plug it in. Another name for plug it in is substitution. We've been doing that forever. So right to the side, plug it in. Substitution is a fancy word for plugging it in, swapping it out. Okay, what we've been doing since like the eighth grade, some of us. Okay? The only three things that you have never seen before probably are these three right here. Reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. And I'm going to tell you the little tricks that I use to remember them. So reflexive sounds like reflection. Okay? And if I look in the mirror, is it the same face looking at me, or is it, when I look in the mirror, do I see Johnny?
I see it.
It's the same face.
I hope not.
Same Depends face. On what drug you're using.
The Johnny drug. So, isn't it true that A would have to equal A? 2 has to equal 2. 4 has to equal 4. 5x has to equal 5x. They're the same on both sides. These reflect each other. Okay? So, symmetric property. Alright, so symmetric property starts with an S. This one swaps spots.
Nice.
Alright, so the S for symmetric, it swaps spots. So, if I tell you that X equals 2 in this equation, can't I say that 2 is equal to x?
Yes.
Yeah, it goes both directions, right? That's kind of like that biconditional. It's true both ways. If A equals B, then B has to equal A as well. Transitive is the only one that's a little
that's
more complicated. So if I say that Keely wears glasses and Brandon wears glasses. And Brandon wears glasses and Johnny wears glasses. What can I say about Keely and Johnny?
They both wear glasses.
Right, because they're both equal to the one in the middle that was repeated. What was the middle part that repeated?
Brandon,
he's that common factor. So, what I always say is if they are, so, things equal to the same thing are equal.
We had to do that when we were doing the first thing, like the first thing we did, because if they overlap,
right,
and they're equal.
Exactly. So he's right. So in here, if A equals B and B equals C, what was the repeat? B. Therefore, I can say that A is equal to C. Okay, and he's right. We led up to that in our lesson yesterday. Those would be the only new ones. And I think about them in alphabetical order. R-S-T. Reflection, swap spots, things that are equal to the same thing and not equal.
Got
so far,
did.
So good? Mm-hmm. Okay. Let's talk about how we're going to use this. All right. I'm going to help you out here, and I'm not going to make you come up with this stuff on
Georgie.
Your own. So, here's what I want you to write in the
statement and reason box.
Yeah. Oh, this one we can do. Alright. So if you never remember anything else about proofs, remember this. Step one is always the given. Always, every time. So step one is the given. What was given to us? Now, anytime I write something over here, I have to justify it with a reason. What I just say this was? Given. Step one is always the given. Now, just like working out a problem, we're just every step, we have to give a reason. All right, so what would be the first step in solving this one?
One and subtract one.
Okay, so he says subtract one. Now, before we do that, if you want, we can go and finish this and then fill in the reasons, or we can do the reasons at the same time. Do you want to just work it down and then go back and do the reasons?
After the reasons.
Okay. What property or why did I do this?
Because you have to get it by itself.
Subtraction from.
Yes, because it happened on both sides. So this is subtraction.
Yeah.
Prop. Good. Okay. Subtraction property. Alright. Now, he already heard somebody say, what is negative 5 minus 1? Equals, what happens? So what was my justification for this? What I do?
Simple.
Yeah, I just simplified it. Right, because nothing crossed here. I didn't do any crossing. I did that up here.
You just copied it down.
Mm-hmm. All I did was just put stuff together. I joined my like terms. Good. So now what do I do?
Division prop.
Okay. Division prop.
What are you writing with? Oh, I didn't realize that you had that in your hand. Because, like, the one was facing outward, and I was like, how is she copying this stuff down?
I know, magic.
Alright, so what do I have now?
Simplify. Because you're writing it back down.
Okay, and I'm going to simplify. Now. Alright, so on this one, I'm sure you've been told that's probably not the best way to write that. How should I write my
N equals negative 2.
Okay, that would be my proper order. So 6. N equals negative 2. Well, what property says that I can swap those around? And if N equals that, it's also got to be true that negative 2 equals N.
It starts with a C. No. Oh, my.
Symmetric prop. Good. So symmetric property says I can swap spots. Because if this is equal to it here, well, it's got to be equal in reverse. That's that biconditional. Okay? So far, not so bad, right? Okay. We are used to doing this.
We're going
to
get our head
started. We're going to start doing it with geometry.
Yeah,
as well. Okay, so we're gonna skip this one for now, and let's go to this one.
I'm not done with that.
I'm a race car.
Okay.
Now,
not listening.
That one is on your.
I didn't think that all the way through.
No, so everybody find it. I skipped the forward. What I want you to do though is I want you to write this down.
Read that.
Okay, everybody should be filling this in.
Break
it back. Back it up. Fuck it up, fuck it up. Fuck it up, fuck it up.
Hey, I'm recording, little Miss Cardi B.
I wasn't singing Bodak Yellow, I was singing Rake It Up.
Oh, that's right, you were, weren't you? Sorry, my bad.
You wrong for an 8, weren't you?
Yeah, and of all two people to mix up, too.
Sing it louder.
Said little girl, you can't mess with me. If you'd like to do that.
Okay, please write down the left side.
Dang, you do that fast.
Go ahead and write down that left side. I'm going to give you time to write all this down, and then all we have to do is let's come do up with... justification for each other. The first hour we did this from scratch and it takes about 10, 11 steps. So I the worksheets, I did not leave them on your own. It's going to be more fill in the blank type of stuff. So I'm going to give you some direction here and then we're going to fill in the reasons of why it happened. All right. So, What I always tell you the very first step always was? The given. So our reason for being able to write step one is it's just given to us. It is given. They also gave us a reason. What was the reason that they gave us? Right, which makes sense. If I add up the parts, it equals the whole. They added KL, LN, it has to equal KN. So the reason here is segment, addition, postulate. Oops, that's a postulate.
I'll put mine on
segment. Prostitute.
Okay? So I'm not going to write that out every time. Segment, addition, postulate. Now.
Stop, Johnny.
Something changed, Johnny. Did you stop it?
No, I didn't stop it.
It was just messing around. All
right, here we go. Number two. Here's how you want to approach this. You have to see what changed. Okay, guys, focus. What changed from KM to here?
What is changing it out of what I'm aiming it at?
Okay,
you can still hear her talking. You still see the board. I don't understand.
Focus.
It's about to go down.
Focus. They have substituted in here. Is that the same thing that happened here?
Yes.
Yes. And the next one?
Yeah.
Yeah. So they looked at this picture and they said, well, KL is equal to this. LM here, the whole thing. So substitution. Now we have to decide what happened from 2 to 3. What changed? Did anything change from here to here?
No.
No. Did anything change from here?
Simplified.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Did anything change from here to here?
Simplified. Right now.
Well, what's missing? So this and this changed. This stayed the same, the two stayed the same, but this disappeared.
Subtraction.
What they subtracted? 3x.
All
right, so they did a 3x here and a 3x here. What property is that then? Subtraction property. Because it happened on both sides, right?
Good job, Becca.
All right. Now, let's look at 5. What changed from here to here? We added what?
4.
Yeah, they added a 4. So addition property. Okay. Now, what happened from 5 to 6? Division. Oh, my help by divide by the right number, huh?
I think it's probably a little my mouth.
Okay, so far so good?
Yeah.
All right. Not so bad, right?
That's pretty easy.
Yeah, right now it is. I agree. It will get harder, but we're good right now. So what we're going to do, go ahead, Johnny. Hold on. Wait. Okay, look back at this. Okay, compare this chart. Okay, I'm going to leave this one up there. Look back at that very first chart. What is different about reflexive property in the first one than this one? What the first one call it?
It's different of congruence.
This one, what was the first one?
Equality.
Yeah. Okay, so the word congruence and equality. If something is equal, has an equal sign, we call it equality. If it's congruent, what kind of signs are in here?
A squiggly line and an equal sign.
What's that called?
A congruent
greater
symbol.
That's a good guess. This means?
Means congruent.
Congruent. All right.
I said that like
so
5
listen,
times.
These properties didn't change. They still hold all the same things, only they change the sign.
Isn't it because they're using like angles and stuff?
No, it doesn't matter. It'll still be all the same. One uses congruent, so it's property of congruence. One's going to use an equal sign, so it's property of equality. It still does the same thing. All right, so go ahead and hit stop. We're going to look at the homework.
Okay.
All right, so let's look at the homework, and we're going